Jake Cutler, he's the man. He's the master of the universe, Mr. Olympia, three times. He's going to take it at least six or seven, I think, if he keeps doing what he's doing. It's going to be an honor to shoot him again. It's been 11 years since I shot him last, so this is going to be great.
Yay!
Today, we're shooting with Perbinal. Doing some action shots of what my preparation is going to be for the Mr. Olympia, which will be a series of photo shoots basically called the Road to the Mr. Olympia competition. My workout strategies to progress and become once again the title holder in 2010.
Every rep is $20. Every photo shoot you see in MD, Perbinal is the man. I get $20 per rep.
And I get like 40.
He gets two.
No.
Yeah. I wanted to be the face of muscular development. I wanted to come back where I could be closer to the fans and let a magazine actually step into my life to get inside. It is the ultimate multimedia magazine out there. That's what we're shooting for. We're going to try to make this thing as much and open as possible in a positive manner and create opportunity for the athletes that are involved to do the best of their ability to promote the sport of bodybuilding and the lifestyle and everything that goes into it, because you can see the workouts, but when you see the lifestyle and what the athletes do, I think that's what matters, what the readers want to see, and that's what we're trying to project in 2010.
Come on, come on, come on, okay. Come on, let's go, keep going. Three, come on, come on, come on, come on,
four. In 2006, I won the title of Mr. Olympia over Ronnie Coleman. And I defended that title in 2007. I won that title again. I was going for my third title in 2008, and I finished second to Dexter Jackson, who now became the newest Mr. Olympia, the 12th Mr. Olympia. In 2009, I began my journey to rewrite history books and become, once again, Mr. Olympia, and I did that. And now, moving into 2010, I'm looking for my fourth title. From 2008 to 2009, a big change in my training. I changed my diet. I hired a new trainer. Started doing the FST7 training, which is a more volume training, movements. I ate more on a specific diet, more red meats, more consistent meals. I worked on getting more rounder muscle tissue instead of focusing on sheer weight and sheer size. I worked on getting more balanced and more symmetrical to bring a much more quality package to the stage. And I developed a strategy that I felt would come in and win the title, and it did.
You're a big guy, man. I mean,
huge.
Nothing compares. Nothing compares, man. That's great.
I've seen him compete. He was a pretty good inspiration. So, hopefully one day.
Yeah, right.
Be there.
Yeah, right. Yeah. I mean, you weigh 150.
That dude is massive. I see why he's Mr. Olympia, no joke. God dang.
Woo! My brand, the Jay Cutler brand, I have all these different trademarks for Jay Cutler, basically marketing the bodybuilder to Mr. Olympia, which is me. So I take advantage of using my name to help promote not only myself, but also the sport of bodybuilding. Now I do this through clothing, I do it through DVDs, and I want people to be able to take advantage of the merchandise that's available. Everyone wants to be part of Team Cutler now. I put out the YouTube videos, which are free at jcutler.com, which allows the fans to watch every 10 days what I'm doing exactly, and see the transitional periods that I go through now since I won the Mr. Olympia title. Leading up to the show, I do blueprints on the website, so they see on a daily basis what Jay Cutler eats. I want to provide as much as I can. Right now, I'm training to win my fourth title at Mr. Olympia. What I'm looking at is between February and June, which is my months in preparation before I actually start full-on preparation in June. So that's as far as I'm looking ahead. And right now, my job is to market it, become once again the ambassador of bodybuilding, promote the sport of bodybuilding in a positive manner, travel around the world for the fans, and now being over at Muscular Development Magazine, reaching out to a whole new fan base and millions of people, not only that follow the magazine, but the best bodybuilding internet site out there. People are coming inside Jay Cutler's world and they're seeing what it is to be Mr. Olympia, and that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to be the most exposed Mr. Olympia ever.
Were you always that wide?
Yeah. Well, not really. I'm pretty big right now. Like, I could get better shape now than I have before.
What do you think, Jay?
Not bad. Not bad. But I think,
Has he learned a lot in 11 years?
I think it was better before.
I think, honestly, you know, today he's going to walk out of here and he's going to learn a few new things now that he gets to shoot the champion.
All the way up. All the way up. Yeah, that's the shot. Yeah, like that. Good, 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 good.
What I learned from bodybuilding is when you begin and you have those dreams and that passion, you have to set realistic goals. But what you never realize along the way is that your experience is life-altering for a lot of other people. You become a role model. You never think, okay, this is what I'm gonna do and I wanna be a role model. You can't really say that because you have to build your image, you have to build what you become. And you only do that through obstacles and overcoming odds and fighting yourself, the demons inside yourself that are gonna be your obstacles in order to get there. So I think bodybuilding has given me that meaning, and it's given me a lot of dedication and passion, not only for the sport that I do, but for life in general. And it's created being a role model for a lot of people, and that's the most appreciation I can get out of it.